Good evening, everyone. It is a pleasure indeed to share with the Orange Hill Church family in the evening of prayer. My name is Allison Perry, and I am from the Church of God at Chelsea Road. Our topic for this evening is living in hope. Our text is Proverbs chapter 13, verse 12, and it says, "Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but desire realized is a tree of life." Hope is defined as to wait in expectation for a desire to be fulfilled. And as believers, we know that that expectation is in God. Our hope is rooted and grounded on our faith in God. Deferred. What does defer mean? Defer means a delay and a postponement. So what is this verse saying? Whenever there is a delay and a postponement of the desired thing, the thing that you have been expecting, or even the promise that you have been waiting for, the word of God says that the heart can become sick. What kind of sicknesses do we experience when this happens? We can experience discouragement, despair, a sense of hopelessness, or we can even become depressed. And these things can cause us as believers to become stuck. My acronym for stuck is staying there until circumstances kill. So when our heart becomes sick, when we have experienced depression or discouragement, we have a tendency to become stagnant in our walk, our relationship with God. There's no sense of expectancy. There's no more sense of excitement. We're no longer excited, or we're no longer looking forward, because our hearts are filled with discouragement. And this is not a new place for believers to be, for when we look at the Word of God, we see some examples of persons who would have been in a place of waiting for the fulfillment of a promise. And this evening, we take a look at King David. David was anointed king to be king by the prophet Samuel. God sent Samuel to anoint him to be king. And this happened while David was just a teenager. And the word of God says that the fulfillment of this promise came to pass when David was 30 years old. Now imagine that. David was anointed to be king while he was a teenager. Some scholars believe it was about when he was about 15 years old, and it took almost 15 years to see the fulfillment of this promise. How did David respond? What was happening in David's heart? When we look at the book of Psalms, we know David is accredited for having written about 75 of those Psalms. And these Psalms were written out of David's experiences. In Psalms 142, this was written while David was in the cave on the run from Saul. Saul was king, and Saul wanted to kill David because he was jealous. And he knew that David was in the place to become, he was already anointed to become king. And so Saul was after, he was pursuing David. And the word of God says that David, in Psalms 142, he wrote, I'm reading from verse 5, "I cry to you, O Lord. I say, you are my refuge, my portion in the land of the living. Listen to my cry, for I am in desperate need. Rescue me from those who pursue me, for they are too strong for me." The word of God gives us an understanding of David's mentality. And I love the Psalms. The Psalms show how vulnerable David was. And we see that David cried out to God. He wasn't afraid to share what he was going through and how he was feeling. He was very much aware of what was happening within him. And David cried out to the Lord. The Word of God tells us that while he was in that cave, around him there were some discontented and depressed persons. It's so funny that on our way to fulfilling the promise or to fulfill the destiny that God would have us to, sometimes we find ourselves surrounded by persons who are feeling very much the same way that we are at that particular time. And we want, and that's not what we want at that time. We want to be encouraged. But I want to say to you that God knew just what David wanted. The Word of God says that a prophet came to David while he was in that cave. And he said unto David, don't stay here, David. Don't stay in the stronghold. Get up to Judah. God is saying to you, believers, those of you who are feeling discouraged and despondent and even depressed, don't stay there. Get up to Judah. What does Judah mean? We know that Judah means praise. Praise God. Get up to the place where you begin to change your perspective. For we know that when we are in the place of praising and worshiping God, we shift our focus from off of ourselves. It's no longer us or our situation or what we're going through or what we're faced with or even how overwhelmed we are. But we begin to see God for who he is. And the Word of God says in Psalms 145, we see the tone, David's tone change. And he began to declare, he said, I will exalt you, my God, the King. I will praise your name forever and ever. Every day I will praise you and extol your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom. Praise God. So David shifted. He shifted his focus, his perspective. He began to see God for who he was and declare praise and worship unto Almighty God. This evening, believers, saints, wherever you are at, however long you might have been waiting for that fulfillment of promise, that word to come to pass, and it feels like forever, I want to encourage you this evening to dress yourself in that garment of praise. The Word of God says in Isaiah chapter 61 that God has given us the garment of praise instead of the spirit of heaviness. Glory be to God. Wherever you are, children of God, begin to praise God, begin to exalt God, and watch that heaviness shift and begin to lift off of you as you dress yourself in praise. The Word of God says that God inhabits the praises of his people. What does that mean? That when we begin to exalt God, when we begin to enthrone him and lift him up, he comes and he dwells in our midst. He comes and he brings his glory and his presence. And glory be to God. And he fills us with joy. He fills us with peace. He restores hope. He restores courage. Glory be to God. He strengthened us. Hallelujah. So dress yourself in praise. You might not feel like, but begin to put on some music in your home. Glory be to God. And begin to dance. You might not feel like, but take the Word of God and begin to read a psalm and open your mouth and begin to declare it in the atmosphere. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul, glory be to God, will magnify the Lord. Come on, think about, remember the things that God has done for you. Look back, look back. Yes, you might be waiting. Glory be to God. But there has been some good times. Glory be to God. Some times when you can declare, if it had not been for God, I do not know where I will be. And this evening, begin to draw upon those times. If even if you call a brother or sister and you begin to, and you allow them to encourage you, say to them how you are feeling. Don't just say, I'm good. If you know that you are down and out and you feel overwhelmed, come on, tell your brother or your sister, come on, pray for me. I need to be encouraged, and let them share their testimony. For the word of God says that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Declare what God has done for you to a brother and a sister, that they too might be rooted and grounded in their faith. Bless God. I encourage you this evening. Keep living in hope as we pray. The word reminds us in Peter that Jesus is our living hope. We can hope because Jesus went behind the veil. He went behind the veil and he made it possible for us to come in to the Holy of Holies. Praise God. He gave us access into God's presence, and we can come boldly this evening. Let's pray. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Glory be to God. Our first prayer this evening, I want to be praying for those of you who might be saying, Sister Allison, I have been down and out. Yes, I'm doing my ministry. I'm teaching my Sunday school. I'm doing these things, but truly, my heart is sick. My heart is in a place where there's despair and there's discouragement. I don't really feel the joy of the Lord anymore. I want to pray for you this evening. I want to pray that that spirit be lifted off of you and you begin to hope in God again. You begin to hope in God. Father, this evening, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for the access that we have, O God, into your presence. Lord, we thank you, O God, that we can come boldly to the throne of grace, O God. We thank you, O God, this evening that we can come and obtain mercy and find help in time of need. We thank you that the veil was rent in two, O God. Hallelujah, Lord God. This evening we rejoice, O God, for the blood of Jesus that covers us and makes it possible for us to come into your holy presence. Father, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, O God. Holy Father, as we come before your throne, O God, we are praying in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, for our brothers and our sisters, your children, O God, your believers, the ones that you have bought with the precious blood of Jesus. Lord, we are praying, O God, for them, O God, we are praying for strength. We're praying, oh God, that you will strengthen them in the name of Jesus. We're praying, oh God, that you begin to dress them in the garment of praise, oh God. Father God, we're praying that you will cover them, their minds and their entire being in the blood of Jesus. Father, we're asking you, O God, that you will break, O God, every spirit of depression in the name of Jesus, every spirit of heaviness, every spirit of anxiety and worry and stress in the name of Jesus. Father God, may it be broken off of their lives this evening, O God. And Father, may they be filled, O God, with strength. May they be filled with courage. May they be filled with peace in the name of Jesus. Lord God, I'm praying, O God, that wherever they have partnered, oh God, with discouragement, Father, that you begin to take them back to that place, oh God, where, Father, they were felt, oh God, that you forsook them, oh God, you left them behind, oh God. Oh Father, I pray in the name of Jesus for healing of their hearts and their souls and their minds, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, for a reassurance of your love. Father God, because your word says that perfect love casteth out fear, oh God, I pray, Lord, that you would reassure them of your love. The word says that hope does not disappoint, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts. Lord, may your children be reassured of your love for them. May they be reassured, oh God, that they are your workmanship, oh God, that you have created them, oh God, for good works, oh God. Father, that you even thought about even before time, in the name of Jesus. I pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus, for healing, oh God, in their emotions, healing, oh God, in their self-esteem, oh God, healing, oh God, in their perspective, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord, that you will fill them, oh God, with courage, oh God. Father God, that they will get up from that place, oh God, and Father, that they will begin to live. They will begin to live. We speak life. We speak the abundant life over them, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we thank you, oh God, for your word, oh God, Father, that is quick and powerful. And even now I send your word, oh God, and I prophesy life, oh God, to their spirits, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Father God, I thank you, oh God, for stripping them, oh God, of depression and anxiety and fear and worry. And I thank you, oh God, for filling them with joy and peace. Hallelujah, oh God. I thank you, oh God, for strengthening them in the inner man, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, oh God, for their minds, oh God, that are stayed on you, oh God, for your word said that you will keep us in perfect peace, as our minds are stayed upon you. Cause their minds to be stayed upon you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray this evening, oh God, that they will be rooted and grounded in love. I pray, God, that the eyes of their understanding will be enlightened, oh God, that they will begin to see the plans, oh God, that you have for them. They begin to see beyond, oh God, where they're at. Oh, glory be to God, and they begin to dream with you again, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, oh God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, oh God, for, Lord, you know the plans that you have for them, plans to give them a hope and a future and expected in the name of Jesus. Father, we cast down every lie that the enemy has told them, in the name of Jesus. Lord, for some that might have made mistakes and feel as though it is the end, oh Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I pray, Father, that the love of God will reach them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Reassure them, draw them back to yourself, oh God. Father, cause them to know, oh God, that you have not given up on them, for your word says in Romans chapter 8 that there's nothing that shall be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus. Oh, Lord. And so, Father, I pray, Lord, Father God, that they begin to walk in truth in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Father, where they are feeling, oh God, weak, Father, I declare your strength. Father, your word says, oh God, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Oh God, strengthens me. And so, Father, I pray, oh God, for supernatural strength, oh God, for them this evening in the name of Jesus, oh God. I thank you, oh God. I thank you. Glory be unto you, oh God, for filling them up with joy, filling them for to the overflow, oh God. I thank you, oh God, for lifting them from that place of despair and discouragement, oh God, and causing them to hope again, causing them to trust again, causing them to believe again in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Father, I thank you, oh God. I thank you, Lord. Father, I thank you. Your word says, oh God, that you are more than able, and you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we ask, think, and desire, oh God, according to the power that works within us. Your power is working within us as believers, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, begin to move in the hearts of your people. Hallelujah. The word says in Job that there is hope for a tree after it has been cut down. Oh, at the scent of water, it shall spring again. Lord God, this evening, Holy Spirit, you are our living water. Oh, begin to move within us in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, and cause hope to come alive in Jesus' name. Oh God, that growth, Father God, that they will begin to walk with you again, they begin to listen to you again, oh God, that they begin to love you again, that they would fall in love with you over and over and over again in the name of Jesus, oh God. Father, I thank you, oh God. I thank you, oh God. I thank you. Encircle them, oh God, with your presence, oh God. Encircle them with your presence. Some of them are saying, oh God, they're no longer feeling or sensing you, Lord. Visit them this evening wherever they're at, oh God, and reassure them, oh God, that you are with them, oh God. Your word says that you will never leave us nor forsake us, oh God. God, glory be to God. Oh God, a righteous man falleth 7 times and the Lord lifts him up, oh God, Father, cause him to know that you are lifting, that underneath them this evening are the everlasting arms, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, oh God, I thank you. Father, we silence all the lies of the enemy, all the whispers in their ears in the name of Jesus. And we declare that they shall hear your voice. They shall hear your truth. They shall hear you speaking to them above the noise, oh God. You are speaking peace, oh God, to their souls and strength, oh God, to their hearts, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I bless you. I thank you, oh God. I magnify you, oh God. I exalt you, oh God. Thank you for restoration, oh God. Glory be to God. The psalmist David say, you are the God that restores our soul. Thank you for restoring us this evening in the name of Jesus, oh God. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord God. We bless you, Lord God. We thank you, oh God. We put our hope and our trust in you, oh God, this evening, for you are faithful. Father, I thank you and I praise you in no other name but the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. 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 I trust that wherever you are at this evening, for those of you who are feeling discouraged, overwhelmed, and depressed, I pray that through the power of the Holy Spirit, that you were renewed and strengthened and encouraged and uplifted. For God is good and indeed worthy to be praised. He is faithful. Hallelujah. I want to pray for those of you in this journey of faith. You've been holding on to a promise, and you've not given up. I want to be agreeing with you for breakthrough this evening, for He's the God of breakthrough. And we know that we are in a warfare. And the word of God says in Ephesians chapter 6 that we wrestle. Our fight is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and spiritual wickedness in high places. We are in a fight. And we see in Daniel that the word of God says that Daniel was in prayer, and the answer was on its way. But the prince of Persia withstood the answer, withstood Daniel from receiving the answer. How many of our answers are being held up by the enemy? We want to agree this evening. If two of us shall agree, we want to agree as touching anything, it shall be done. And we want to be agreeing this evening for the manifestation of those promises for breakthrough. God has a set time, and we want to agree this evening for those of you whose time it is, that indeed that you would have received the breakthrough that God has promised. Father, we thank you, O God, this evening, for you are the God of breakthrough. Thank you, O God, because your word tells us, O God, that every promise of you are yes and amen, O God. And we thank you for this, that you are faithful to your word, O God, and to your promises. And O God, we are praying this evening in the name of Jesus, that you will send your angels of breakthrough, O God, to bring, O God, the answers, O God, to our prayers, O God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we are praying, O God, and declaring breakthrough, O God, for your saints. Father God, we are praying for financial breakthrough. Father, for those who have been praying, O God, and asking, O God, for financial blessing, O God, our release, O God, we are agreeing this evening, O God, for breakthrough in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, O God, we declare, O God, Father, breakthrough for them, O God. Father, we are praying, O God, for breakthrough for those who've been praying for healing, O God, in their bodies, their physical bodies. Father, wherever, O God, they've been praying, maybe a back, O God, Father, foot, O God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, you know those who are sick, O God, who've been crying out to you. Father, we know that you are the God that can heal, O God. You said healing is the children's bread. And this evening, O God, we declare, O God, that by the stripes of Jesus, we have been healed, O God. So we declare breakthrough, O God, and healing, O God, for your children in the name of Jesus, O God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, let there be a manifestation manifestation of your power in the lives of your believers, oh God, in the name of Jesus, as they cry out unto you, oh God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We are praying for breakthrough. Glory be to God. Some of them have been praying for loved ones. God, it might have been a son, oh God, or daughter, oh God, that do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as Savior, a husband, a wife, oh God. Father, we're believing you for breakthrough, oh God, for salvation and deliverance for them in the name of Jesus, mighty God. Father, show up, oh God, on the behalf of your people, for you are the God of breakthrough, oh God. You are the God of the impossible, oh God. You said that with God, all things are possible. And I declare you over every situation. I speak Jesus, oh God, to the finances that are held up. I speak release in the name of Jesus. I speak Jesus, hallelujah. Glory be to God for the healing in the name of Jesus. I speak Jesus, hallelujah. I speak Jesus, hallelujah, for the souls, oh God, that need to be saved. I speak Jesus and his deliverance over their lives in the name of Jesus, God. We snatch them, oh God, from the camp of the enemy, oh God. And Father, we declare that they're walking in your marvelous light this evening, oh God. Glory be to God. Father, you said to ask and we're asking, oh God. You said to knock and we're knocking. You said to seek and we're seeking. You said to call and we're calling, we're calling, we're calling, we're calling in faith, oh God. We believe you, Father God. We believe you, oh God. We put our trust and our confidence and our hope in you this evening in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And Father, I thank you, oh God, I thank you. I thank you, Father, I declare that you have gone before your children, oh God, and doors, oh God, that were closed, oh God. Father, we command them to open in the name of Jesus. We declare that they're walking into purpose. They're walking into destiny in the name of Jesus. We declare, God, that crooked paths will be made straight in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh God, because you have gone before them, oh God, this evening. Father, we thank you, Almighty God. We thank you, oh God, for showing up. We thank you, oh God. We speak and declare Jesus, oh God, to every situation. Hallelujah, Lord God. And we thank you for breakthrough this evening. We thank you that there's nothing too hard for you to do, oh God. And we partner with you, Lord God, and we confess, oh God, Jesus, over every situation, oh God. Father, we thank you, oh God. We thank you, Father. We bless you and we honor you and we glorify you this evening. Hallelujah, be unto your holy name. Thank you, Almighty God. Thank you, Almighty God. Thank you, Almighty God. Father, thank you for doing it, oh God. Thank you, oh God, for moving in the lives of your people. Thank you for the answers to our prayers, oh God. Thank you for the mighty deliverance, oh God, in our lives and in the lives of family members, oh God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you, oh God, for bringing every plan of the enemy to naught. Father God, we thank you. We declare, oh God, your word that says that we are more than conquerors, oh God. Father, I declare your children, oh God, Father, they're walking in your power and your anointing, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And they're standing in victory, oh God. Hallelujah, Lord. I bless you and I glorify your holy name. God, I thank you, oh God. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you. Praise your holy name. Praise your holy name. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. We just want to be praying for those that do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as personal Savior. I want to encourage you that you can live in hope when you become connected to Jesus, who is the source of hope. Hallelujah. We see all that has happened, you know, suddenly, just like that, the world changed. But I want to encourage you this evening that Jesus Christ remains the same. He is the same. The word says he the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And so you can put your faith and you can put your trust in him because he does not fail and does not disappoint. You might say, but I've tried him and it did not work. Try him again. Glory be to God. Put your hope and your trust in him again. He does not disappoint. Father, I thank you. Oh Lord, it's a privilege to call you Father. We thank you for this beautiful relationship that we have. Hallelujah. We thank you for the joy that we experience in serving you, oh God. We glory in the fact that you know us. You know, oh God, every hair on our head, oh God, is numbered. You know us so intimately. And so, Father, you know the persons that are listening, oh God, online. You know them by name. You know where they're at. Father, we pray that through the power of your Holy Spirit, you will continue to draw them unto you, those that do not know you, oh God. Father, we declare over them that they will taste and see that you are good. You are good. You are good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in you. I pray for salvation for them. I pray for deliverance. I pray, oh God, for hope in the name of Jesus. Lord, if there are some who are feeling like giving up, who are feeling suicidal, oh God, I pray that they will get up from that place, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you will call them by your Spirit, oh God, call them, visit them wherever they are at in the name of Jesus, and Father God, draw them unto yourself, oh God, and save them and deliver them, oh God, from the power of the enemy, God, that they will live to fulfill their purpose and their destiny in the name of Jesus, for you have a plan and a purpose for their lives. God, we thank you. We thank you. Bless them. May they feel your love. May they feel the warmth of your presence. May they sense you, oh God, wherever they are at in the name of Jesus. Be real to them, oh God. Oh Lord, we think about Saul. Oh God, when he was on the way to Damascus, oh God, a hard man, oh God, Jesus, you met him, oh God, personally. I pray for an encounter, oh God, that persons would have an encounter with you. Meet them wherever they're at. Meet them in the name of Jesus. Lord, that they will be transformed by your power. In Jesus' name, God, we thank you, we thank you, we praise you, oh God, we praise you. We continue to pray for peace over our nation, over the world, oh God, with all that's happening. We pray for the peace of God to reign in the name of Jesus. We pray for the love, Lord, let there be a love, oh God, for our neighbors, our brothers, oh God. Father, but may we first know you, oh God, and know your love, oh God, that after having experienced your love, Lord, that we would understand how to love like you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Pour your love out upon us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray, oh God, that you will continue to give wisdom, oh God, to our leaders, Lord, we thank you, oh God, for all that you have done so far, Lord. Father, we pray for wisdom in the name of Jesus to maneuver this crisis, oh God. We know that you are not asleep. And so, God, we pray for wisdom. We pray for your direction. Lord God, we thank you, oh God, for strengthening our hearts. May our hearts not faint, oh God, but we continue, oh God, to trust you, oh God. May we continue to put our confidence in you. Lord, we thank you, oh God, we thank you. Father, we thank you. We see how you were able, oh God, in the midst of a famine, you set up Joseph, oh God, and you gave him the insight, oh God, oh Lord, as to how your people would maneuver in that time, oh God. And Father, I pray the same, oh God, that you will set up persons, oh God, and give them the wisdom and the knowledge and the understanding, oh God, Father, that we be able, oh God, to successfully maneuver, oh God, in this time, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, oh God. We continue to speak death, oh God, upon COVID-19. We speak death. We speak death in the name of Jesus, and we pray for the life of God. Father, I thank you, oh God, that you are the life giver. Jesus came that we would have life and more abundantly. And so, God, we call upon you that the life of God will begin to flow over our nation, oh God, and you would rescue persons, oh God. Father, we thank you, oh God, this evening. Father, we thank you, Lord. Let your will be done. Father, let your will be done, oh God. Let your will be done in the name of Jesus. Be glorified, oh God. Be magnified. Be exalted. Be praised, oh God. And Father God, I pray, continue to pray, Lord. Father, that we, oh God, will be examples of hope, what it means to live in hope. I pray, oh God, that as your children, oh God, that out of our mouths, oh God, will be words of hope, oh God. Father, that we be able to declare, oh God, Jesus to those that do not know him, oh God. Father God, that when others are speaking, oh God, words of despair and depression, oh God, Father, that we be able to speak words of courage and hope, oh God. Father, in the name of Jesus, help us, oh God, to declare Jesus, oh God, to every situation, oh God. Father, help us, oh God, to trust you, oh God. Strengthen us, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Father God, that we indeed, Father, will be examples. We will be the salt and we will be the light, oh God, during this time. In Jesus' name, oh Father, in Jesus' name, oh God, help us, oh God, that when we are tempted to doubt, that you would remind us of who you are. You would remind us, oh God, of your promises. Strengthen our faith, oh God, and steady our hearts, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Help us to guard our hearts, oh God, as your word said, oh God. Help us to guard them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Father, we bless you, oh God, and we thank you for this time that we have spent in your presence. Continue to bless us as your people, oh God. Thank you, oh God. Oh God, we thank you for inviting us to your table, and we thank you for the spread that you have prepared for us, oh God, and we thank you. This evening we eat and we drink, oh God, and we are strengthened and we are renewed and we are encouraged, oh God. Father, we praise you, we bless you, and we honor you in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you for joining us this evening. We pray that indeed your hearts have been refreshed and encouraged. Saints of God, keep hope alive. Remember, Jesus is your hope. Glory be to God. And this hope we have as an anchor for our souls. Glory be to God. There's a hymn in the Church of God that we sing. We have a hope within our souls, greater than the perfect day. God has given us his Spirit because the Holy Spirit lives within us, who is the guarantee of our inheritance. So even by that, we are assured that what God has promised will come to pass, because Jesus said, I'm going away, but I'm not going to leave you alone. I'm going to ask the Father to send another helper, the Comforter, and the promise came to pass. So we have this treasure. So the psalm says, God has given us his Spirit, and we want the world to know it. All our doubts. Come on and declare this evening, all your doubts are passed away, because your hope is built on nothing else than Jesus' blood and righteousness. Because of the covenant, glory be to God, we can stand firm and secure. Trust God this evening. Trust God. Praise God. Have that expectation of God and know that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you ask, think, and desire, according to the power that worketh in you. God bless you this evening. Glory be to God.